Welcome. In this video, we'll explore the assignment problem and application of linear programming. The assignment problem deals with the challenge of assigning resources to tasks in the best possible way. For example, matching workers to jobs, scheduling machines for tasks, matching agents to projects, or assigning salespeople to territories. Importantly, the assignment problem is a special type of transportation problem in which both supply and demand at each point are exactly one. This means each resource, like a worker, can only be assigned to one task, and each task can only be performed by one resource. Our goal with the assignment problem is to find the optimal one-to-one matching that either minimizes the total cost, like labor cost and travel time, or maximizes overall efficiency, e.g. productivity or output. Here we have four employees A, B, C, D, and four tasks. These are the costs of assigning each employee to each task. For instance, assigning employee A to task 3 costs 8 units, and assigning employee C to task 2 costs 15 units. These units could represent dollars, hours, distance, or any other relevant metric. And here is the complete network. Our objective is to assign each employee to precisely one task, ensuring that all tasks are completed while keeping the total assignment cost as low as possible. To formulate this as a linear programming model, we first define our decision variables. Let Xij equal 1 if employee I is assigned to task J, and 0 otherwise. That is, the variables represent a yes or no decision. Here, I represents employees A, B, C, D, and J represents task 1, 2, 3, 4. For example, if XB4 equals 1 in the solution, it means employee B is assigned to task 4. And if XA1 equals 0, it means employee A is not assigned to task 1. Since we're minimizing costs, our objective function looks like this. We're minimizing the sum of all the assignment costs. Where assigning A to 1 costs 10 units, A to 2 costs 12 units, and so on. Remember, since the Xij's are binary, 0 or 1, only the costs associated with assigned tasks, where Xij equal 1, will be included in total cost. Now let's look at the constraints. For each employee, we need a constraint to ensure they are assigned to exactly one task. For employee A, the constraint is XA1 plus XA2 plus XA3 plus XA4 equals 1. This means that employee A must be assigned to task 1 or task 2 or task 3 or task 4, and to only one of them. We write similar constraints for employees B, C, and D, ensuring that each employee is assigned to exactly one task. This is a balanced assignment problem because we have the same number of employees and tasks. In balanced problems, we can use the equality constraint because we know every employee will be assigned and every task will be done. Note that some textbooks will use less or equal to signs for resources or employees, whether the problem is balanced or not. Now, let's consider the tasks. Each task must also be assigned to one employee. For task 1, the constraint is XA1 plus XB1 plus XC1 plus XD1 equals 1. This means task 1 must be assigned to employee A or B or C or D, and to only one of them. Again, we write similar constraints for tasks 2, 3, and 4, ensuring that each task is assigned to only one employee. Finally, we add the binary constraints. Xij must be either 0 or 1. This is essential because we cannot assign half an employee to a task. And there you have it. The complete linear programming formulation of the balanced assignment problem. Now, let's briefly discuss what happens when the problem is unbalanced, meaning the number of employees is different from the number of tasks. First, consider the case where we have more employees than tasks. This implies that not all employees will be assigned a task. In this scenario, the employee constraints change from equality to less or equal to 1. This allows for the possibility that an employee is assigned to at most one task. In this case, 3 employees will be assigned the 3 tasks, and 1 employee will be assigned no task. Conversely, if we have more tasks than employees, then every employee must be assigned to a task, so the employee constraints will remain with equality. However, not all tasks will be assigned. Therefore, the task constraints become less than or equal to one constraint. This means that a task can be assigned to at most one employee. It's worth noting that in courses where employees or supply constraints are consistently expressed using less than or equal to signs, a common technique to handle the case of more tasks than employees is to introduce a dummy employee. This dummy employee does not represent a real person but serves as a placeholder to balance the problem mathematically. Also, in solvers that require a balanced problem, we typically create dummy employees or tasks to equalize the number of employees in tasks. The cost of assigning any task to a dummy employee is generally set to zero. This ensures that assigning a task to the dummy employee does not affect the overall objective function, which we're trying to minimize. The employee constraint for each real employee and the dummy can thus be equality constraint, ensuring each employee is assigned to a task and the dummy effect is to absorb the unassigned task. By introducing dummy employees or tasks, we represent the unbalanced scenario within the framework of a balanced assignment problem, which allows it to be solved using standard algorithms and software. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.